Okay, so we're almost done with Rico Harbor now. The Watermelon Festival again. This time we have to get the actual Shine Sprite from here. Alright, so same deal as before, let's try and get rid of these Cataquacks. This time, we don't have to worry about collecting coins as well. Okay, I think that'll be good. Time for the hard part, actually getting this watermelon to the juice bar. Yep, and it already popped. Leave me alone! Can't even see properly here. And it popped anyway. Oh, got it past the Cataquax. Now to get it to the actual juice bar. There we go. Now that's a big old watermelon like I've never seen. Alright, we win. I don't think it's safe to stand on that thing, Mario. But at any rate, we have 60 Shine Sprites now, so we are halfway done. Yep, Gelato Beach is now fully completed. Did I ever get this Shine Sprite from this warp pipe over here? I honestly can't remember. No, I haven't. I completely forgot about this one. Can't believe I forgot about that one, but at least we got it. Okay, so with another world completed, we need to be finding the next one. The next one on our list is this one. Alright, so welcome to Serena Beach, and the first episode is called The Manta Storm. Okay, so we're at a different beach this time. Now you might have noticed that this paint or goop is a different color. That's because this one is electrified. Not fun. See, just barely touch it and you'll get shocked. Now, is there a blue coin around this corner? Yes, there is. Alright, now I may very well be trying to get 100 coins from this episode, because I think it's one of the easiest to do. It's just really time consuming. Thank you. really need to spray water everywhere here so we can try and find every single coin. It's not gonna be easy. Oh, that's interesting. Getting a 1-up completely refills your water. I had forgotten about that. Now there are coins in the trees, but I'm gonna hold off on getting them just for now. These guys are chopped. Oh, and I looked it up, and these guys are actually called Nokis. I had been calling them Mokis. That was close, though. I think there's a blue coin hidden under one of these roofs, but it may not be until a later episode. May not be until a later episode. Now, even though this is a very time-consuming shine sprite to get, it's probably one of the easiest ways to get it, I think. Alright, so if you're trying to collect 100 coins in this stage, whatever you do, don't talk to the guy that's standing, like, right there. That dude there. Because that's what triggers a boss fight to happen in this stage. And if you're trying to collect coins, well, that's going to make it difficult. Halfway there. Let's start collecting the coins from the trees. Okay, just 15 more to go. I think that's all the ones from the trees, though. So, let's start looking. Finally! That felt like it took forever, but I finally made it appear. Now, there's a good chance I'll I'll have cut footage of this, but it would have been boring just seeing me running around trying to scrape a couple more coins together, so, yeah. Oh well, at least we got it in the end. And at the very least, at least we got the 100 coin shine sprite out of the way in the very first episode. Alright, let's do this. Now, coming up is what I would consider one of the most difficult bosses in the whole game. So let's try to clean up this goop first. We want a little of this electric loop if possible, especially for what's coming up. I already got the blue coins for that, so not much point talking to them again. I'm surprised these guys can actually, like, stand in this game, because it is electrified. Let's just clean up this mess, and then we're good to go. Now remember, the boss fight will start as soon as you talk to this guy over here, so make sure you're ready. Okay, I think we're good to go. Let's go ahead and talk to him. Oh, please tell me my nightmare is over. You can save me. I don't know why, but you just look very capable to me. Listen, it all started around noon. This giant manta-shaped thing showed up. It was this paper-thin floating silhouette. It came and covered the hotel grounds in this electric goop. Then, oh, the horror, my beautiful hotel, my poor building. It sank in the middle of that awful ooze. Why me? Now I've got the staff cleaning up, but where's my hotel? What am I supposed to do? I can't just sit back and... Ah, it's back! That gossamer ghoul! Do something! Oh boy, here we go. So say hello to the giant manta ray. Alright, so the whole goal of this boss fight is to break up the manta ray into smaller pieces. Once all the big pieces have been completely broken down, then all the small pieces are going to come after you. Which can be both a good thing and a bad thing. Oh, we broke all the big pieces, now they're coming after us. Huh, this wasn't nearly as difficult as I remember. See, that's where it can actually get, this boss fight can actually get difficult, because the mana rays can bounce you around, and there's a good chance they may bounce you onto electric goop as well. Well, it looks like we're taking care of them quite nicely. Almost got him. Alright, we got him. Huh, that wasn't nearly as difficult as I remember. I used to really struggle with that boss when I was younger. Well, at least we got his hotel back. We've only got 3 blue coins from Serena Beach, but at least we got, like I said before, at least we got the 100 coin shine spread out of the way. Alright guys, so I think that's gonna be about it for now. Next time, we'll be doing more episodes from Serena Beach. See you then.